Homeless individuals in our community are a growing concern, and there are several hurdles they must face in the process getting back on their feet. One includes obtaining identification.
23 ABC's Leslie Gooden has been working on a story that breaks down how not having an ID can impact the quality of life for homeless individuals and how this real ID transition in the state is having some real hurdles for that population. Leslie.
Yes, not having something as simple as an ID card for homeless individuals can stop them from getting food, housing, and even job opportunities. Today, I was able to speak with a homeless individual who used to be homeless, who tells me how difficult it was for him to get his ID.
An ID is probably the first hurdle that I would suggest you get out of the way. You can't really do anything without an ID. Matter of fact, you can get in trouble for not having one when you're walking around by the police.
Chris Morrow says that he was homeless in Bakersfield 4 years ago. During that time, he lost his Social Security card, birth certificate, and ID. He says most people living on the streets don't have one or several of these critical documents, which he and other experts say can be the biggest hurdle to navigating the process to getting a job, housing, or critical services.
One of the first things they did for me was to get me my identification. California has some amazing programs. As a matter of fact, the IDs are free now, but the one thing is you have to verify you're homeless. And so in order for us at the mission to verify someone's homeless, that means they stay with us.
In 2015, the state passed a law that would allow homeless individuals to receive a free copy of their birth certificate. In 2016, homeless individuals were allowed to receive a free ID card through a verification program.
Discouraging and unfortunate how long it can take to get an ID. But that's where service organizations come in, and we need to keep people engaged so that we can help them move off the streets and into a new life.
With the state requiring all individuals to have a real ID, navigating the process for the homeless can be made exceptionally difficult if they don't have documents to support who they are.
The whole thing with the real ID coming out, it's going to pose a challenge as an organization, we will work with the staff to try to work, you know, with DMV services, because that is going to pose it, because it's a whole different set of guidelines that they're looking for.
The Real ID requires two documents, a proof of residency, a Social Security card or W-2 form, and proof of identity. Luis Gill, the homeless center, and Carlos Baldovinos from the mission at Kern County both agree most of the individuals that live on the street do not have all these documents.
County and service providers are soon going to be bringing new projects forward that are going to provide a place for people to stay. We need members of this community to stand up and say, we want that to happen. We need that to happen. We need them to stop saying, don't do it near me.
You were made for so much more than this, and I just say, let us come help you. Come to the mission and let us help you get your life back in order. I promise you it'd be so much better and it'd be so much worth it.